is sponsored by Kirchner Building Centers.
We're at Kirchner Building Center with our favorite handyman, Dakota Kirchner. Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. I'll be better when I learn a little bit about how to spruce up a room in my house with some paint.
Oh, we're going to cover that.
I know you are, and we're going to cover some walls in your office because, quite frankly, Dakota's a cute boy. He needs a cuter office, so we're going to help him out with that today. We're going to start with the important beginning of painting, which I have learned from you and along the way many others. And that is preparation is key.
Correct. You want to make sure your wall's clean, your baseboard's clean, whatever you're painting, trim, or whatever. So you can scrape that off with a magic eraser, or just wipe it down. If it's new drywall, you'll want to prime it just so the paint sticks to it, or new wood, you'll want to prime it just so the paint sticks.
Okay, and like what about when you have pictures hanging and you've already had them there and you have little nail holes?
If you got little nail holes, you can just fill it with a little bit of spackling and then rub it off and paint over it.
And it's good to go, right?
Yes, ma'am.
But the preparation is the critical part here, and not just as far as you said, wiping the walls and making sure the surface is ready, but I am a huge lover of frog tape. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, frog tape's great. It covers your baseboard, cover your corners. Whatever you don't want to get paint on, you tape around. It's got this cool little powder on the edge, so it keeps the paint from going underneath it, kind of puffs up, sort of. When you peel it off, it doesn't peel the paint with it, so it's just a very good product.
It comes off very easy.
It does.
I like that as well. Because, you know, back in the day before frog tape, you'd try to use masking tape, and inevitably you'd mess something up along the way. So it is a great product. Also, the brush that you use is a critical part, especially when it comes to trim.
It is. For trim work, you can use your angle sash brush. You can get right up next to the trim without really painting on it, so that's a big plus. Your bristles, you have different bristles for different types of paint, stain. Oil-based, you'll want to use more like a natural bristle, or synthetic, you can use your latex.
And I'm always a big fan of rollers when it comes to the large surface areas.
Yeah.
So can you talk about that?
You got different size of rollers, so if you're doing a bigger wall, you can use a bigger roller. If you just want a normal size wall, you got your typical 9-inch, or you can go down to 2 or 3-inch rollers and do for smaller areas.
I had never seen one of those big giant ones before. I'm like, where was that when I was painting like the family room wall? Because that's really nice, actually.
It is. It's a good way to cover a lot of space.
You have all of the tools people need here, but you also have some of the best paint in the industry with the Valspar. Can you talk about that as well?
We keep Valspar Medallion, which is 100% acrylic, so it bonds better to an already painted surface or a prime surface or whatever. It covers really well and blocks out darker colors even better.
Now, when it comes to the priming part, I know Valspar's Medallion paint says it has a primer in it, which in most cases is going to work for you. What are the examples of a wall where you would actually want to prime first?
If it's new drywall, bare wood, something that doesn't previously have a coat of anything on it, anything slick, surface, you'll want to do is like a bonding primer.
Okay.
Stains, you can use your stain blocker primer just to make sure it covers well and you don't see it through the paint.
Literally, paint can change an entire room.
Oh, it can.
I feel like it's a simple weekend project that somebody can do that can make all the difference. But before they do the weekend project, this is where you guys come into play. If they have questions, if they want to know about specific products or all of the tools we've talked about, you guys have it all, right?
We do. We do.
And where are your locations?
You can visit us online, figure that out. We got 12 stores, so just swing by and see what you need.
And online at?
KirchnerBuildingCenters.com.
Okay, so I'm going to, I'm like a teacher. This is our lesson plan. One is prep, right? Two is tools. And three is you're crazy if you don't shop at Kirchner's. How's that for a lesson?
Looks great.
All right, there you go. We're at Kirchner's Building Center in Marshall, Illinois with Dakota. Make sure you stop by for your next painting project.